Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to WWE News and Rumors. I am your host, Mr. Brandon Hodge.
This video is brought to you by the WWE T-Shirt Club. If you guys want a brand new WWE shirt delivered to your door every single month, just hit the first link in the description and sign up.
So the first news story of the day, the first news story I have for you guys is that, ladies and gentlemen, today was one of the days, I guess I could say. So this is about WrestleMania 37. Tickets for WrestleMania 37 for an actual crowd to be there. If you're a fan and you live in the United States, you can go to WrestleMania. Today was actually the official pre-sale, so they did the pre-sale today. Tomorrow is the official on-sale day, so the on-sale tickets are tomorrow. But as for today, they did the pre-sale, and I can officially say, ladies and gentlemen, Brandon Hunt, and that's me. I got a ticket for WrestleMania, guys. Actually was able to be lucky enough. I believe at least the combo tickets are like completely sold out right now. If you want to go both days, I think individual days they may still have a few on the pre-sale, but the pre-sale is pretty much sold out at this point. And I was on there this morning at 10 o'clock. I was able to get some tickets, not necessarily where I was wanting to sit. I'm like section 200 and something, and I'm like, what in the hell? But you look at the prices and it's like $350 each or something, and it's like a crazy amount of money. But anyway, I will be there. I actually have a video where I actually go through the process of buying WrestleMania tickets and my experience doing that, and that video will be coming out tomorrow. But anyway, guys, the news story here is WrestleMania pre-sale was today. They're pretty much sold out at this point, but tomorrow they'll have on sale where they're going to release like thousands of more tickets. So if you didn't get a chance to do the pre-sale today, tomorrow will probably be your final chance. So get on there if you live in the United States and you want to go to WrestleMania. All right, the next story is about Shawn Michaels. Shawn Michaels is not someone I really talk about too much here on the channel because he is retired. But obviously, he came out of retirement for one match, that Crown Jewel match that ended up being a disaster. You know, everyone has their off nights or whatever, and pretty much everyone in that match, that particular match, had an off night on the same exact night and just weren't feeling it. They weren't really working good, and they just kept messing up, and it's no one's really fault. But anyway, Shawn Michaels has came out now and said he really wishes he would have just stayed retired, and he regrets actually coming out of retirement for that Crown Jewel match, and that's coming directly from Shawn Michaels himself. All right, the next news story is actually about Andrade. So Andrade has been someone that's really been in the rumor mills in the past, few rumor mills. Why do we call it a rumor mill? Is it because they just pump out things? Anyway, I don't even know what I'm trying to say here. Anyway, Andrade has, there's been rumors about him that he requested his release from the WWE. And then there was another rumor that came out that saying WWE denied his request to be released out of his contract from the WWE. So basically, Andrade wanted to leave the WWE, wanted to be released out of his contract to be free to wrestle anywhere else in the world that he pleases to. He wanted to be released out of the contract. Basically, WWE rejected his request or whatever. That was a rumor. But if you notice, it still says news down there. So why does it still say news down there? Apparently, I saw it on Twitter this morning. Andrade himself tweeted, "Yes, the rumors are true. I don't really know what the future holds for me, but I do know I have a lot of people behind me supporting me." So that's what Andrade said. Andrade did actually ask for his release. It was rejected, but apparently WWE is supposedly coming up with a new plan for something, you know, good to do with the guys. Hopefully they do that. But obviously, when you're at a point where you ask your release from the biggest wrestling company in the entire world, you really just feel like your character has no direction and you're like kind of the end of the rope there. But hopefully Andrade finds what he's looking for in pro wrestling and in WWE here soon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so that's actually the only confirmed news stories I have for you guys today. But don't you dare go anywhere, guys, because things are about to get good. Things are about to get juicy here on the Brandon Hodge channel. I would go ahead and suggest for you guys to get your juice boxes out, get your juice boxes ready, because things are about to get juicy around here, because ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to talk about some juicy rumors. All right, the first rumor has to do with WrestleMania 37. So WrestleMania 37 is having a limited crowd. There's some rumors going around that they might be changed into 100% capacity if they were freaking psychopaths, but they've decided not to do 100% capacity and they're staying, I think. I mean, it's not much lower. It's like 70% or 75% or something. There's a lot of like blank spaces, you know, in between people, because they're doing the pod seating where there's gaps in between the different pods. So the question remains, are we just gonna leave that gap, or are we gonna do like the Super Bowl did? And what the Super Bowl did, if you don't know, they had cardboard cutouts in the like empty seats to make it look like it was full and completely sold out on TV, even though it wasn't. Everyone knew it wasn't. It just came off better on TV, especially if you're watching in a year where you can have large crowds again. It just doesn't seem so out of place. So it's a fairly good idea. It comes out good. As far as like WWE doing something like that, Vince McMahon, when he saw it in the Super Bowl, apparently he loved the idea. He absolutely loved the idea of it looking full on TV. But now apparently Vince has grown a little soft on the issue, and now he's not really too sure if he's going to do that. I mean, it's probably a big expense to have all those like cutouts and those blank spots, plus probably fans will take them and take them home and or whatever, and you can't use them again in the future if you ever need to. So it's probably an investment to get those things printed, because they probably cost like $50 each to print out, and then you gotta have thousands of them, so it adds up. I don't know if Vince is gonna do it or not. It'll come off better on TV, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Alright, the next rumor is about the pirate ship. Some of you watching this right now are probably gonna be like, what in the hell are you talking about, Brandon? Well, okay, so WrestleMania is in Tampa Bay. It is in the Buccaneers stadium or whatever. They have a big pirate ship. It's like one of their logos or whatever. It's a big pirate ship that they use for NFL games that they have there. Like, it's a legit giant pirate ship. So the question remains, is WWE gonna do something with that? Is a wrestler going to jump off of the pirate ship onto someone? It's a bigger question. It's a larger question. As for that, there's rumors that they might actually be covering up the pirate ship with a big tarp because it's gonna be behind the Titantron or something. So who really knows? If they have someone to jump off of it, then it's gonna be there. So if we see the pirate ship, more than likely someone's gonna jump off of it. But if we don't see the pirate ship, it's just covered up and it was like inconvenient to like move it around or whatever. So I have no idea, but I mean, it would be cool like to have a big pirate ship for like the stage set up, but who knows? We'll just have to wait and see. Okay, the next rumor is about a WWE backstage interviewer. Normally I don't talk about the interviewer themselves, but I guess sometimes we have to. So this one's about a lady of the name of Charlie Caruso. Hopefully a lot of us have seen Charlie backstage. Now she hasn't really been doing too many interviews recently, and the rumor is that she's been showing up like late to interview people, and apparently it like upset Vince McMahon, the boss man, being like, why are you showing up late to interview people? Apparently she was like late to an interview with Randy Orton and late to an interview with Sheamus, and apparently that rubbed the boss the wrong way, and he hasn't really been keeping her on TV much. So I mean, really pissed off the boss getting on Vince's bad side, unless you had like a ridiculously crazy excuse for being late. You're probably not gonna be used on TV too much more, and hopefully everything's okay. She can explain herself. Hopefully she had a legitimate reason for being late to an interview. I mean, if I was interviewing wrestlers, you know, I would be on time. It's a big deal. It's a big job. And I know once you do it for a while, you can stop taking it so seriously, but still, it's a big deal. But anyway, guys, Charlie Cruz, hopefully she'll be popping back up and doing stuff here soon. All right, the next rumor is about Jimmy Uso. So Jimmy Uso is the other Uso that hasn't been, you know, with Roman, the Uso that threw in the towel in that match, whatever it was, I Quit match or whatever like that. Anyway, Jimmy Uso has been injured for quite some time. That is not why he's not with his brother Jay. That's why they're not going after the tag team championships right now. So the question remains, when is Jimmy Uso going to be cleared? When is Jimmy Uso going to be back wrestling in the WWE? Well, apparently he's ready. Now is the time. So literally any day here soon, we will see Jimmy Uso back on WWE television. I guess he will be joining his brother doing the whole Roman thing, or maybe he can get the Usos back together as a tag team and do stuff like that. But apparently Jimmy Uso is medical cleared now, and he's ready to return literally any day. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the saddest part of the entire video, to be honest with you guys. Go ahead and get your tissues out, get your tissues ready, because ladies and gentlemen, this is the final news story, this is the final rumor, this is the final thing I'll be talking about inside of this episode of WWE News and Rumors. This is about none other than The Fiend, Mr. Bray Wyatt. So this Sunday is Fastlane. This Sunday is the next WWE pay-per-view. Actually, the final pay-per-view before WrestleMania. I actually did my predictions yesterday. If you guys didn't check out my Fastlane predictions, go ahead and do that. After you finish this video, of course. But anyway, at Fastlane, we have this match. We're having Randy Orton, the Viper, wrestling a woman. So what's this? Intergender match? Is this actually happening? We haven't seen this in WWE in a very, very long time. For, I guess, the PG reasons, I don't know. But we have Randy Orton versus Alexa Bliss, the goddess. So they're supposed to be wrestling each other. Alexa's representing the Fiend because the Fiend was burned alive and he's disappeared. So, I mean, this is pretty obvious what's going to be happening. Apparently, this is pretty much the set plan, is this will be the return of the Fiend. This is when the Fiend will return somehow from being burned alive. He will return and save Alexa Bliss from having to wrestle Randy Orton or whatever. So, it's going to be interesting to see where they go with this. Just for a Fiend return, I wish they would have just had him, like, pop up out of nowhere and just surprise everyone. Instead of, like having some kind of, like, semi-obvious thing being like, Randy Orton's gonna wrestle Alexa Bliss. It's like, no, he's not. That's not happening. Fiend's gonna return. It's pretty obvious there. I mean, I guess they have kind of a habit of doing that. I'm not trying to hate or anything. I just, like, just have the lights go out on Raw and Fiend appear or something like that. Or have the lights go out at Fastlane without building up something kind of ridiculous match like that. But, I mean, that's just my personal opinion. I mean, they're still doing a wonderful job at building WrestleMania the best they can. Fiend versus Randy Orton appears to be a match that will be happening at WrestleMania. I've heard rumors of a Firefly Funhouse, but we'll have to wait and see about that. But yeah, that is the final rumor. It will be the Fiend's return to the WWE will be this weekend at Fastlane. So you guys, that is actually going to do it for this episode of WWE News Rumors. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Right now on screen, I'm going to leave a link to two previous videos for you guys to check out, as well as a button to subscribe to this channel if you're brand new here. But thank you guys for watching this video. I am Brandon Hodge, and I will see you guys in the next video.